So today, in this first message in the series, which is more of an introduction, I want to awaken our hearts and minds to this truth of our identity in Christ. The objective of this series of studies of our identity in Christ is to help us understand who we are in Christ Jesus, the grace that God has poured out on our lives in Christ, and the rich inheritance He has given to us in Christ. Now, some of the ways this truth is going to affect our lives, it will change our self-image, how you see yourself. You and I, we will learn to look at ourselves out of our new identity in Christ. We will learn to say that who we are in Christ is who we really are. Secondly, this truth will change the way we relate to God. I mean, when we understand that this is what God has done for us, and He invites us to, you know, come freely into His presence, we will not approach God as somebody who's always trying to please Him or appease Him, or as though God is angry with us. But we will understand that we are accepted, we are loved, we are welcomed into the very presence of God, and so we can come freely into His presence, and the way we relate to God will totally change. Thirdly, it'll change the way we face life's challenges and difficulties. When we face challenges and difficulties in life, which all of us will, we will learn to look at them from our place in Christ. We will learn to look at them as more than conquerors. We'll learn to look at them knowing that God will cause us to triumph in Christ. It'll change our lifestyle. We will live as overcomers. We will overcome sin, our sinful patterns. We'll be transformed from inside out, and we will be more and more like Jesus Christ. It also changed the way we face demonic powers and Satan and his demons. We'll be fearless, we'll be bold, we will walk with a sense of absolute mastery and dominion in the face of demonic powers. It'll also change the way we relate to people. We will learn to look at people in a very different way, the way we relate to them. We can walk in love, we can walk in compassion. We will not walk with a sense of competition or feelings of inferiority or any of that. It'll change the way we actually interact with people when we understand our identity in Christ. Now, we're going to spend a little bit of time in Ephesians chapter 1, verses 1 through 14. In this passage, he uses 16 descriptors of the believer as they are in Christ, of the believers as they are in Christ. 16 descriptors. You know, this is what he refers to as believers. He says, because we are in Him, because we are in Christ, because in whom we have all this. Now, I'll just run through these 16 descriptors. You know, he says, we are blessed, we are chosen, we are holy, we are blameless, we are covered in love, we are predestined for His purposes, we are adopted as children, we are people for His praise, we are accepted in the Beloved, we are redeemed, we are forgiven, we are recipients of abounding grace, we are gathered as one, we are given an inheritance, we are sealed with the Holy Spirit, we are purchased possession. 16 different descriptors. This is who you are in Christ. This is what's happened to you in Christ. In these 14 verses, repeatedly, he uses the past tense, meaning this is a finished work. This is not something God is planning to do out in the future. He says this is something God has already done. Let me read out some of this, you know, how he uses the past tense. In verse 3, he says, who has blessed us, already done. Verse 4, he chose us, means already done in Him. Verse 5, he has predestined us to be adopted, already done. Verse 6, he has accepted us in the Beloved. Verse 7, we have redemption, present tense. Verse 11, we have obtained an inheritance. Verse 13, we were sealed with the Holy Spirit. So look at all of this. It's all work that has already been done. It is a finished work. So this is the way God works. God finishes the work. He completes the work for us. And then He invites us to live out of that finished work. He says, I have chosen you. Live as somebody who's chosen. I have blessed you. Live as somebody who's blessed. I have redeemed you. Live as somebody who's redeemed. I have sanctified you. Live as somebody were sanctified. So we have become a new creation in Christ. But this new man needs to be continuously renewed. Like the Passion Translation says, it is continually being renewed. This new man needs to continually grow in the knowledge of the one who has made him new. So the point I want to bear is on our hearts is this, that this study, this is something we must continue to grow in our understanding, our revelation of our identity in Christ.